so that we have three basic functions of accumulation, starting from the basic function is the to let the reservoir fluids into the well from where it can then flow or pumped to the surface. The second target or the second basic function of well completion is to keep over or underlying the water cut out of the well. Also the to keep the formation out of the well. So if we are talking about the well completion design, we are talking about the top level completion design objectives. The top level completion design objectives target the optimized production, also target adequate monitoring and servicing, also the suitable components for well environment and the changes, and the reservoir strategy. We will sustain the reservoir strategy. Also, we will ensure the return on investment or ROI. When we are talking about the petroleum economics, the great terminology for ROI is very valuable and to be taken into consideration, the cost-efficient installation, also the reliability, also the risk management, and how to manage the cost and the target, and also to achieve the business value for your well completion technology. Last target or last objective to be at any time, for, we are talking about the safe well security and environment regulations. The secondary target or the secondary level completion design objectives, talking about the production conduit with optimized flow, also talking about the component material selection and evaluation for every technology and for every type of spare parts or completion accessories. Also, we are talking about the installation or stimulation, production and removal challenges. To identify what about the failure modes, what about the severity, what about the probability of failure for any items or for any completion tool. Also to generate the contingency plan or emergency plan when we are talking about the failure in design or failure in operation. Also to ensure what about the top level objective. So when we are talking about the well completion design process, we are talking about a very complicated process. But when we are talking about the design process, we will focus on the design philosophy of well completion. The design philosophy of well completion is to maximize the profitability by the first one to maximizing the well hydrocarbon recovery. And the second target or the second objective is to considering the full life cycle of your well or hydrocarbon recovery. So when we are talking about the process, as you see that we are starting from define and justify key well objectives, this will define what about the reservoir exploration strategy, what about the surface constraints, what about the lifetime requirements, monitoring requirement, and the workover or recompletion operation. And all of them will focus on the cost model for the well completion design. The second step is to identify what about the your objective, what about your targets, and if you collect all of this, you have to confirm what about the visibility for your technology. When we are talking about the completion design process, we have to define the inflow model, its IBR model, and also we have to define what about the outflow model. When we are talking about the inflow model, we are talking about the rock and fluid data, we are talking about the well geometry, what about the communication of your reservoir, what about the, your stimulation operation, and also what about the controlling mechanism. If you are talking about the conventional well completion, you have to define what about the surveillance data, what about the well testing, what about the sand control, what about the tubing size, what about the artificial lift method you will utilize or you will add in your well completion in the future. All of this will combine what about the detailed design and what about the detailed program or the procedure. So all of this will answer what about the requirements. If you are meet the requirements, you have to define what about the visibility, what about the optimization, what about the design model, and to compare between the cost and benefit analysis. So that the well completion design process is not an easy operation, but when you are familiar with the technology, when you are familiar with your reservoir and also your wells, and what about your requirements and the targets, you will define the optimum design solution with a great technology or a beneficial technology. The old fashioned technology of conventional well completion, I know that this is technology is still worked nowadays, but its technology, talking about the mechanical action or solid equipment, when you are talking about the completion accessories, we are talking about five groups, starting from the anchoring device. The anchoring device as the landing nibbles, as you see in this sketch in the right side, we are talking about the top no-go nibble and also the bottom no-go nibble. It's a very an old fashion of the technology of the conventional well completion. The second group, we are talking about the circulation device. The circulation device to circulate or give you a mean of communication between the annulus side and tubing sides, like a sliding side door or SSD. Also, when you are utilize gas lift or chemical injection, you will be utilize the side pocket mandrel for any operation regarding the circulation means. The third group will be the isolation device. The isolation device as bucker or tubing seal assembly or BBR. Also, the fourth group is the anti-erosion device. The anti-erosion device, we have two devices or two spare parts or two accessories in the well completion. If you are talking about the internal erosion, you have to utilize the flow coupling. And if you protect your completion from the external erosion, you will utilize the plus joint. So the plus joint will be across the perforation zone or interval zone, and the flow coupling will be installed at a critical flow like a downhole safety valve or the landing nibbles. The fifth group or the last one group is the other accessories like wireline entry guide, like perforated bob joint, like control line, and also the tubing hanger accessories. Now, we will define some of the completion design parameters for production optimization. When we are talking about the completion design optimization, we are talking about the reservoir challenges. We have many different reservoir challenges, like the early water or gas breakthrough, like the high water production, high gas production, also the sand production without any control, also the underbalance influx. The second group as the completion objectives. The completion objectives, you have to define what about your target rate? What about the isolation intervals? What about the fracture control or isolation mechanism? If you have a shale barrier, if you have an isolation regarding your cement integrity or quality for your drilling and completion operation. And also how to overcome the above agreed reservoir challenges. And the third group for optimization is the well data. It's a very a great group with parameters regarding the fluid and rubber properties, the completion type, what about the mechanism for your artificial lift, what about the recovery mechanism, you are now in primary recovery or secondary recovery or tertiary recovery. All of this will control what about your completion design, what about your philosophy, what about the return on investment and the business value for the well completion. Now we will define what about the smart completion and what is the great benefits or what about the innovations in this technology. A smart completion is defined as one that provides the ability to both monitor and control at least one zone of a reservoir. So that it means that completion with permanent downhole monitoring is defined as a smart completion. As in permanent downhole monitoring, we are utilize the pressure and temperature sensors. We are utilize the flow watchers or flow rate device. Also the water cut monitoring or water cut sensor. The second group will be the surface operated downhole flow control. The surface operated downhole control, flow control can control what about the sharing or the production contribution from your intervals or from your reservoir section. At surface, you can control what about the rates, what about the contribution of any interval, and you can control and shut off any area at any time without any well intervention in your well. So that the operation will be controlled through two types of control. The first one is the hydraulic operated flow control valve, and the second one is the electric operated flow control valves. So when we are talking about the simple definition of a smart completion, as you see here, this picture is four or five gate valves in the same pipeline as this horizontal pipe. And every valve have a control pressure, have a control temperature, and will control the flow to some areas or the port or the interval of this valve. And every time or all of life cycle, you can control and monitor your flow rates, your target zone. Also, you can eliminate any type of fluid like water, like excessive gas, to delay. What about the water problem? What about the gas problem? And all of this will add value for you as you have to keep the surface operated downhole flow control. You have to keep the permanent downhole monitoring, and all of this will minimize the well intervention operation in your well. The case history for the first application of the smart completion. The first smart well completion was installed in August 1997 in North Sea. This is in the offshore area. This technology at initial time using the permanent downhole electronic gauge and sensors, but in 1998, Well Dynamics use direct hydraulic and mini hydraulic systems. This system developed by Halliburton and also Schlumberger companies. The development of new monitoring system like fiber optic also with high level of accuracy, high level of resolution, and also the stability is very good. As you know that the technology of digitalization or motivation technology utilize the new system for the smart completion technology. Now the question is, what is the business value? If you will spend a lot of money or expensive cost on the smart completion, what about the business value? The business value starting from to eliminate or reduce well intervention cost, also accelerate the production from your reservoir or from your wells, and also to reduce the well cost. If you can produce more oil and gas from one hole or from one well, you can reduce the well cost actually. And also to reduce, what about the surface facilities? As you know that the water production or sand or gas will headache your surface facilities. And at this case, you have a great constraints in your production rates. But the smart completion will reduce the surface facilities cost and also the operating charges or the maintenance charges. Last one, we will increase the ultimate recovery from the your reservoir and no more for trapped hydrocarbon or no more for water production, no more for excess gas will coming to eliminate your production with the smart completion. So it will help us to mitigate what about the reservoir uncertainty. Any reservoir engineer can define what about the pressure, what about the temperature, what about the production contribution. And at any time, you can make or perform production while production operation, while production operation, you can get more about the surveillance data. And also nowadays we are defining this as logging while production. Logging while production is a terminology for smart completion, as you can achieve the logging operation or well surveillance operation while you produce your well, without any well intervention, without any mean of shutdown or closing your well. So the controlled commingled fluid, if you have two layers or three layers, and you will utilize the conventional well completion, it's a very great complicated, and the design will have suffer from the many challenges regarding the commingled fluid. But in a smart completion, you can control what about the production rate, what about the contribution from each zone, and also manage what about the water or gas breakthrough. All of this will also mitigate what about the cross flow or the sieve zone or depleted zone, will achieved by smart completion. Also, the third benefits or business value will be to manage water distribution. If you are talking about the water injector well, or if you are talking about the secondary recovery using the water injection or water flooding, the main problem or main challenge to what about the zonal allocation? What about the water distribution or water influx in some area or some direction? You will focus with a great volume of water injection, but in some areas you will not achieve the target from for your well injection process. So the smart completion will have a great benefits as the smart completion depends on the monitor and control your condition of downhole at any time. The fourth target is to accelerate the production. And when we are talking about accelerated production in complicated reservoirs or in commingled reservoir, you have to know that the smart completion will give you the chance to increase your production rates and accelerate the recovery and increase the recovery using this technology will have a great benefits, not like the conventional completion. The question is, when we are talking about the smart completion, where it will work, where it will work, what is the preferred types of reservoir, or what about the great benefits of your challenges? The great benefits of smart completion will work in complex reservoirs like compartmentalization or layered or multiple reservoir. Also, when you are talking about the complex well architecture like horizontal, like multilateral well, like ERD or extended reach drilling wells. Also, when you are talking about the complex reservoir mechanism, starting from secondary recovery or tertiary recovery, or when you are talking about EOR. So the main benefits or the main challenges of the environment like offshore area, like deep water and remote environment, and especially in subsea fields. The smart completion in these cases will have a great benefits and business value to achieve your targets and to maximize the recovery from your reservoir with a great technology and a remote access and remote control for your operation. So the challenges of this technology as the location and the environment also he need more complex reservoirs. Also, he need more complex recovery mechanism. This technology will increase CAPEX and OPEX. CAPEX is the capital expenditure as it's have a great cost technology. And the OPEX is the operating expenditure. But the intervention operation will be eliminated or reduced for a minimum. As you know that you have the technology for a smart completion, you have to monitor and control at any time without any intervention or any rule. Also the need for better reserve recovery efficiency. So the smart completion will work at efficient and have a great values in the good resources and in the great recovery and great resources in your reservoir. But if you have a limited reserves or a limited recovery efficiency, you will not have the great benefits or the business, the great benefit values for business from smart completion. Also, one of the great challenges is the real-time optimization. People in our world now talking about the digitalization, talking about the remote control, talking about the monitoring from different locations. This is well achieved by the smart completion technology. When we are talking about the smart well completions, we have to know that we are illustrating the elements of the smart well completion. The elements of smart well completion, starting from the power and communication devices, and also the field solutions like flow control, like flow monitoring. So we have three groups. The first one is the flow control devices. The second one is the flow monitoring devices. And the third one or last one is the flow optimization. And every time you have to know, you have a system. This system is operated by a mean of communication and also a power system. And all of data you are collecting from this system will received or will collected in surface at any time. You have to control from your well site. You have to control and monitor from SCADA system or the control unit. Also, you have to know that you can control from a remote location using the satellite or using the application. All of this will have a great benefits of smart completion. So the components of smart completion, starting from the old technology or the past technology of permanent downhole sensors, also the surface operated downhole flow control valves. It's a very great technology or tool in smart completion. Also the communication devices like control lines, the electric cables, also the connection of cross coupling and cable protectors. When we are talking about the horizontal well and we are talking about the open hole sections, in smart completion, we are using the multi-board production bunker or isolation bunker. This technology of permanent downhole gauges or surface operated downhole flow control valves, also the control lines and electric cables, the cable protectors, the multi-board production and isolation bunkers, in two cases, in a case hole and also in the open hole sections. Also the surface equipment like tubing hanger and the Christmas tree have to be fitted and ready to optimize and control the many types of control line, many types of connection and protectors. In surface also, we have to operate using a control panel or a data acquisition system. Also the monitor or data visualization, and also we are using the interpretation software to collect all of this data and analyze and process your data to get the great benefits. As you see that the elements of smart well completion technology is starting from the downhole condition, as we have a flow control device, we have a means of communication using control lines and electric cable. Also the tubing hanger connection on the wellhead or Christmas trees in the left side. Also the control panel and data acquisition system. This is the technology of smart completion. the first or the simplest technology of smart communication is the permanent downhole sensors. The permanent downhole sensors have sensors for pressure and temperature, have sensors for the flow meter, have a sensor for water cut, and also the temperature arrays. This technology using hydraulic control line, using electric cables, also using the fiber optics technology, all of this technology can called or named as a flow watchers or monitoring devices. Monitoring devices or flow watchers classified into pressure sensors, flow measurement devices, electric water cut meter, also pressure flow stations sensor, also a densometer, and the formation arrays in the EOR or the water flooding or water injection. The second type of technology, the second element of this technology is the downhole flow control valve. The downhole flow control valve have two types of or two means of control. The first one or the most common is the hydraulic actuated type. The hydraulic actuated type have a direct control or direct communication using the hydraulic control line and can control at any time the contribution and the production sharing from your production zone or from your reservoir. So we have a direct hydraulic valves require a minimum of one control line per valve. Every valve have to be controlled using hydraulic or electric cable. Also, these valves can be in two modes. The first one is the on or off mode, and the second one is adjustable or discrete position mode, as if you have a variable sizes or variable controlling on your valve or your reservoir. As you see that the two types or the two main types of downhole flow control valve, the right side one is talking about the electric inflow control valve. And in the left side, we are talking about the hydraulic inflow control. These two types controlling using the hydraulic control line as in the left side, and in the right side, it's controlled by electric cable. And this is the technologies for flow inflow control valves using the hydraulic or electric connection. The recent technology of autonomous inflow control valve. Autonomous inflow control valve, this valve are automated or self-regulating and don't require any external control or force. The closing effect of water and gas is much higher for AICV compared to the conventional type or the bus type of ICD inflow control device. So the advantage of using the automated or autonomous inflow control valve are maximize oil production and recovery, cost saving, eliminate the rig intervention, and also avoid new facilities or new coming for water handling. This valve is automated and self-regulated and don't use a great control, even it's have control of it's regulating himself without any using or interface from any person. Just you have to define the best benefits of this application of AICV or autonomous inflow control valve. The autonomous inflow control valve applications based on the viscosity difference between the fluids, the AICV will define what about water, what about oil, what about gas, and at this case, will shut off or control the unwanted fluid autonomously without any interference. So the technology of AICV have a great benefits for water shutoff and also for gas shutoff, as the know-how of this technology is using this device in the bottom part of the slide. This device will define what about the viscosity and also what about the difference between the fluid types, oil, gas, water, and will control the production from any zone or for any area, resulting the hearing gas in this case. So, the third technology of control lines and cables. We have here two types of control lines and cables, starting from the technology of hydraulic lines or hydraulic control lines and the electric cable, also using the fiber optics technology or distributed temperature sensing. Sometimes we have to using the multiple lines like a splice system or a backing system. Back system is to handle different types of lines or control lines and connection. All of this technology will added to smart wheel completion to give the communication type of means, and also cable or control line have to collected and have to installed in well using a cable protectors. Cable protectors have the target of protection or more protection of your cable when you are running hole or install or give and function of any cable, you have to control this by the cable protectors, like the technology of ESP cable. You have to utilize the cable protectors, and this protectors or this coupling is the most common use in our industry, like ESP or technology. The technology for isolation system as in smart communication, we are utilize the multi-board backers. Multi-board backers as the old fashion or old technology for backer, not have boarded or not have boards. Board is very great, important or very important in smart communication, as the control lines or electric cables or fiber optics will pass through the body of backer to control elements more, to control smart devices more. So it's allow passing of control lines. When you are talking about main technology for multi-board backers, we are talking about the production backers as to provide isolation and anchoring devices. Also, we are talking about the isolation backer. It's like a very great benefits in open hole sections, especially open hole backers. Open hole backers depends on the technology of a swellable backer technology. We have two technology for a swellable backer. A technology working in hydrocarbon media or oil media, and the second technology working in water media. This technology, like if you have a rubber element and this rubber put it in oil or diesel, this rubber will inflate or will swell and will damage. This is the technology for swellable bunker in oil or hydrocarbon system. The second one, I have two mechanism like osmosis system. Osmosis system regarding the main function of water, as we are utilize water with high salinity or with a percentage of chloride or salinity. This is will utilize the salinity property to give the action of the swelling mechanism, but indirect effect, not like rubber or like oil media. Also, the technology for wellhead and tubing hanger, wellhead also and tubing hanger have to be multi-ported like this photos, and have to pass many cables and control lines through it. So we are using the control line and the cable penetrators. It also like the design or like the technology of ESP pump in this case. The question now is how does it all come together? As you see in this completion design, you have to define what about your perforation, what about your reservoir. And when you are collecting all of this system, you are using the downhole sensors, pressure temperature gauges, as you see in the last side of this picture. Also, you are using the flow control valve, you are using the fiber optics cable, you are using the flow control devices. All of this technologies is, it's a smart completion technology to get the benefit of control and monitor all of time your reservoir and your condition. All of this tools and equipment will be collected and will be controlled through a surface control system. Surface control system have two or three means of control, like electric cables, like hydraulic controls, like fiber optics cable or line. And all of this will monitor downhole sensors, and you can transmit this data or transport this data or transfer this data to SCADA system or any remote location, or using your mobile apps, using the laptops, any type of control. Now, the smart completion not stop at the mechanism of monitor and control. Also, the smart completion is still have a great benefits to be applied or to be combined with the artificial lift technology. The main artificial lift technology will be ready to combine with the smart completion. It's the gas lift and the ESP. But the ESP have a great benefits, as ESP have a very great rates and can working in the wells for the late lifetime, not like the other artificial lift technology. And when you are talking about the great resources of oil or gas, you have to utilize the smart completion. And if you have a great benefits to apply the artificial lift, if you combine between the smart completion and the artificial lift like ESP, at this in this time, you will add a great business value to your system. So the benefits of combining the smart accumulation with ESP or electric submersible pump, the first benefit is to dedicate the ESP energy to lift more oil rather than water. Also to apply the higher drawdown to low productivity area or low productivity reservoir zone, and to reduce the size of downhole ESP gas separator and gas handling equipment. Also, the one of the great benefits of combining the smart accumulation with ESP is to reduce the ESP size to better match the oil lifting requirements. So in this case, you will reduce wear and tear effect due to the gas slugging or due to the surging effect of gas. And also you have to maintain the reservoir protection during the ESP workover. So the technology have a very great tool. It's a hydraulic line with Wet Med Connect. This hydraulic line with Wet Med Connect, it to provide a connections for hydraulic control line in two stages. When we are talking about the smart completion, we will define two terminology. The upper completion part, and it's have the own design, and the lower completion part. The upper completion part will contain the tubing, will contain the control line, will contain the tool, but it's the above the reservoir area section or the interval section. When we are talking about the lower completion part, the lower completion part will have a smart completion backers, will have sensors, will have a flow control valves. Also, we'll have a connections between the lower elements and the upper part. The upper part will allow the retrieval of control lines and clamps above the top smart accumulation backer with ESP. ESP will be botted at the upper completion part and will be controlled and managed and operated by the control mean of power cable and hydraulic control line or electric cable. This system will be consisted of the first item or the first part is the receptacle. Receptacle is that element is running with the lower completion. And the second components of the hydraulic line with mid connector is the stinger tool or stinger element. It's a tool or it's a device that is run with the upper completion. So now we are talking about the smart completion. Smart completion have a great benefits and business value in our industry. Especially when we are talking about the innovations, when we are talking about the digitalization, when we are talking about the business value and to eliminate the well intervention. So the references or credits of my presentation is coming from the great service providers like Halliburton, Schlumberger, Baker Hughes, and Inflow Control. And also Saudi Aramco, great achievements in this area of smart completion. For your info, Saudi Aramco have a great achievements and published more than 50 SPE papers talking about the smart completion and talking about the different technologies like permanent downhole gauges, like smart completion combined with ESP using the hydraulic line with mid connector. Also have a great paper in Khafji, have a great paper in Sefania Field, have a great paper in Ghor, also in Harad area. Even the smart completion worldwide, like North Sea section, like American or South America section, also in West Africa, in subsea technology in West Africa, have a great benefits and business value introduced by this technology. This technology still have more and more R&D every day. Researches and development for this technology is still have a great benefits for oil and gas industry. So thank you for your kind attention, and if you have any question, you can I can answer on it. Okay, thank you.